Hello students, today we are going to study the third unit of e-commerce. This is applications in business to consumer, that is B2C, where we will cover product and online shopping. Now, online shopping process is simple. Let's see what is the process. First is finding the right product. This is created by effective search engines supported by browsers for selecting a narrow range of products. Second step is that the information can be acquired by reading the product description through images, zoom, ratings and reviews. This also builds an opportunity for cross-selling and solution selling. Now see, online shopping, we already know that it is a part of a life and most of the students are involved with this process. The important part of studying this topic over here is that what is the right process and what is the quality process, how it can be made easy. Making easy is that you need a good website and a good server. If the shopping is right and if the solutions are right, you have opportunities for cross-sellings and upsellings and for solution selling. Now, what is cross-selling is that if you want to buy laptop, you can also search for a laptop bag or you can find pen drives in the market. So, cross-selling is the connected products which are available to the related products in form of complementary designs and solutions. Solution is if you buy a product, you need a service to perform it. So, solution selling is also important in online shopping. This opens opportunities and markets for business people and gives comforts to the customers. The online process also involves placing the order through the internet as easy if there is transparency in cost of purchase of goods and services. The promotion of products can build repeat purchases. See, process is when you place an order, it has to be secured. It has to be transparent, that is the price has to be fair and the budget has to be decided by the customer. If your budget is meeting the prices, you can buy it. But if the companies float good prices and good promotions and discounts, the customers can go for repeat purchases. And by this, the branding and the customer relationship can be built up. So it is important for the company that when the order is placed, they save the data and try to convince the customer through the promotion and the online solutions given for the usage of the product. The post-purchase notifications are also important in online shopping. The post-purchase notifications involve first is the order confirmation, the total price, shipping and the expected delivery date. If the customers are not satisfied, then the return should be made simpler with prepaid return labels and merchandise pickup facilities. Here when we try to do shopping is that when the products have been purchased, it is the duty of the company to send the notifications and the messages to the customer through the mails or through the SMS so that the customer can read these messages and can prepare himself to collect the products or schedule his time according to his availability at home. If the customer is not satisfied, then the return should be easy. That is, the pickup facility has to be there and prepaid labels, that is the amount of the money which is required for refund should be available. Now let's study the modern trends impacting the online shopping business. Online shopping is profitable, of course, because profits are important for all companies. Online shopping can create a mainstream experience. Selection of goods can increase online shopping. Specialty retail sites show rapid growth and there is use of interactive multimedia making impacts the sales of products to be more. Now when we study the trends, we see that the shopping is profitable and there are profits for the company and the customers also get attracted. But when we involve in online shopping, the kind of the specialty and the designer and the specific needs become important. because the general and the mass products are always available for customers everywhere. So if something is new, innovative and connecting, the customers can buy and pay the money which the vendors are asking for. The multimedia is the impact of all the graphics, the designs, the colors, the audios and all the visuals which we put to bring up the presentation of the products and the websites in an effective way so that the customers are happy and they connect to the website in a sustainable and a secured way. The trends basically continue in form of that retailers can help in integrating multiple channels. The sale of customized goods and apparel has become more popular. Online shopping becomes more multi-seasonal. Most online shopping occurs at work or in evenings at home. Retailers are integrating multiple channels that they are connecting to the customers through all the channels, whether it is through internet, via websites or blogs. All the channels are used so that the customers genuinely get attracted to the products and they have a faith in the company. The advertising is done through all the media which is available for the companies to connect, whether it is TV or it is YouTube or other internet websites or it is through blogs. The sales of customized products, apparels, goods, fashion has become popular and most of the customers are taking more interest in these items because they are getting convenient selection in an easy way. Now let's study the factors impacting the online shopping. It is the firm value chain which is formed. It is the core competency built up. It is the synergies acquired, the technology designed or supported. It is the social and the legal challenges. Now the basic factors, now let's discuss in detail. First is the firm value chain. Value chain is the supply chain. Supply chain is the back end chain that is connecting how do we get raw material from vendors and these vendors give it to the manufacturers. The manufacturers give it to the retailers, that is you have dealers in between and then the retailers connecting to the customers. So we have the online value chain is little bit different from the traditional chain because in online in chain we have big portals which support all the vendors. Like if you go to Amazon, that is a website which is supporting all different suppliers and sellers where the buyers, the merchants and other people can connect. So the supply chain is shortened where a direct communication between the customer and the manufacturer can take place and here the dealer can be abolished. But if the dealer is able to buy products from the manufacturer directly and has the advantage of cash discounts, he can lower the price and sell it to the customers. So the customers can directly connect to the dealers also. Core competency is increasing professionalism and efficiency in specific areas. Specific area is that manufacturing is different, production is different, marketing is different. So if you have competency in bulk buying or if you have competency in advertising and promotion, the companies, the websites take the support of other areas and other blogs so as to make the product attractive and make the product visible to the customers. So core competency is different for different areas and different companies and websites have different competencies and specializations to cash on in the market. Synergies is the positive impact. If we synergize, that is the products, services synergize, a package is formed. Like an airline sector can connect with the hotel sector to give you a total package. The concept of package is a kind of a new concept which has lowered the cost for the customers. The customers get a combined package where overall kind of a costing is lower and profits for the companies are also lower because they get more sales. So they can compromise for the lower profits and a synergy is established in the market between the various sectors so as to establish a kind of a positive impact of cutting cost, giving reasonable prices and fair prices to the customers and building value in market. Technology is a system, it is a kind of a protocol designed through softwares to impact the convenience of the customers and the vendors. The technology support infrastructure is important for all, for even the customers to have a basic internet connection and for the vendors to have that protocols of softwares to collect the information and the data of the customers. The social and the legal challenges are immense because the social norms are changing, the frustrations are increasing, choices are widening, the variety demanded by the customers is ever increasing. So, the immense challenges offered by the social media, the merchants have to meet them. The criticism is there, the positive reviews are there. So, we have to meet this interactive marketing channel so as to build and innovate our products in a better way. The legal challenges are there because everything is recorded. Everything is generally designed in a software and a system is recorded and the IP addresses can be traced. So, we have to be very careful that when we are going online, what kind of information we are feeding on the websites and how we are reacting to the customers and what kind of things which we are paying to them. Creating relationship and experience in the marketplace through online shopping and business to consumer transaction basically impacts interactivity, choice boards and personalization. Now, let's discuss in details. What is interactivity? Interactivity is a face-to-face interaction directly with the company's office or the company board where we write and try to get the solution for the product problems and the difficulties. Or we even ask for solutions when the procedures of applying for admissions or applying for bills is complicated. The portals are so large that to get specific service in a specific area is difficult. So, we have a kind of a interaction in terms of FAQs. FAQ is the frequently asked questions which solve most of the frustrations and the problems of the people. The choice boards are the kind of the open portals where customers write about their favors, their positive values and their frustrations so that the people can read and build up a favorable vote and design their innovations in terms to favor customers. Personalization is one-to-one interaction with the customers to solve the specific problems of the customers and connect with the customer to give him value and look into his details so that you can add a valuable client to your company. The online experience basically relates to the context, the content, the customization, the connection, the communication, community, and commerce. So, these are the few C's which impact your online experience. Let's discuss in detail. First is context. Context is the basic background in which we are talking to the customers. Is it a social media or a legal media or is it a business media? So, every media requires a different kind of a language and a different kind of opinion rated reviews. We have to be very careful when we are dealing with customers. Social media is more informal and it is more generally in terms to connect with the customers in an informal way. But when we write on formal portals, it is important that we build our brand and we build our basic image in the market. Content is the kind of the information which is shared on the websites, through YouTube or through mails. What we are sharing, we are writing, the content gives a reflection of the maturity and the identity of the speaker. So, it is important that when we write or we build content for the websites, we reflect a character and value to the society. It is important that the content has to be decent, it has not to be biased, it does not have to hurt religion, society, any caste or any country. We have to respect all religion and cultures in order to have a positive connection with the society. Customization is the detailed connection with the specific needs of the customers and to tailor-made their products according to the packages designed by them. Connection is the kind of the basic internet connection which you send messages, confirmation, acceptance or declining the kind of the favors or the rejection of the appeals and the suggestions given by companies or customers to each other. Communication is how do we connect to each other either by a channel or by websites or through internet or even by phone calls. Community is the total stakeholders involved in the community because when you share information, when you build content, it is not only the users which are impacted, but it is the total society and the community in form is impacted by your thoughts and the stakeholders who are impacted by the branding of your companies, people can increase their business and can lose their businesses if positive or negative aspects is written about the companies, because people work as agents, people work as retailers, people work as dealers in the market also. Commerce is the total business. Business is the vast community impacting the total expansion from the value chain directly to the people who are farmers, vendors, merchants, retailers, dealers and customers, all connect in a society to exchange services and products. Now, why do customers buy through online shopping? Let's see these areas why customers are impacted. First is the convenience, second is cost, third is choice, fourth is control, fifth customization, and then communication. We have already discussed these points, but I'll shortly do it, because convenience is the ease with which we get into the kind of the connection with people. It is easy to write and easy to get answers. The WhatsApp, the Facebook get us the easy convenience connection with anybody anywhere in the world. The cost involved is low, because when you talk on telephone, it is little costly. When you write letters, lot of paper is involved. But when you impact the virtual media, the cost is literally very low, because you have gadgets in your pockets. The choice is immense, because the global market is open, the global society is open for you. So it increases the choice of deciding either for your educational institutes or for your travels or for your banks or for your products. The options now are available to you are globally. The local choices have crossed the barriers of physical societies and have crossed the community barriers, and people have started connecting to cross-cultural issues and have crossed those barriers also, and people are connecting to other societies and other communities. Customization is matching the needs of the customer with the vendor, and communication is again the kind of the connection which we need. Now, the communication over here is designed by the web communities, the blogs, the spam, the buzz and the viral marketing. Now, this is important, because these are the basic trends which are impacting the markets, and we are going to study each factor in details. The customer experience is built up by the cost, the dynamic price, the control and the portal cookies. What is cost is the amount of the money which a customer is investing and the value he gets for the return. That is, if you are investing amount of money, you also want information that may be comparative or about the details or about the usability or the service solution or any kind of search which is required to make a comfortable decision making for your life. Dynamic prices is the prices are changing according to the seasons and according to the market promotion which is happening in the companies. There are seasons where the prices are high because the demand for the product is very high. Like for airlines and for destination, the entertainment industry goes high in vacations, but there are seasons when you have low markets in terms when the weather is negative, that is in monsoons you have tickets which are lower prices. So these promotions can promote the customer to connect and take the price advantage in off seasons also. Control is that whether to accept or not to accept basically depends on the customer. The control over deciding, choosing and building a kind of advantage for him is with the customer. The portal cookies are impacting the businesses in a positive way. Now, let's study the interactive marketing in a detailed way. Interactive marketing involves two-way buyer-seller electronic communication in a computer-mediated environment in which buyer controls the kind and the amount of information received from the seller. See, interactive marketing is that you have the control over the impact which you want to share. How much information you want to share with the customer depends on the company who is building the website. Interactive is, it's a basic viral environment in which we are sharing only what we want to show to the people, And if the product has some defects, we are basically hiding those defects. So interactive marketing is if people get into direct interactions, they can find out those things and get into a connection for building better solutions and innovations in the market. Choice board is an interactive internet enabled system that allows individual customers to design their own products and services from a menu of attributes of price and delivery options. See, choice board is like you can add on or you can subtract the features or the variations you want for a service or for any product. Every service and every product has a different price. The menu is there, you can sort, select and make your bill. This is only possible for ticketing, for hotel industry, for entertainment industry, that is the tickets you are buying, and also for the products which are available in kinds of paths. Collaborative filtering. Collaborative filtering is a process that automatically groups people with similar buying intentions, preferences and behavior to predict future purchases. Collaborative filtering is a process where customers show interest regarding the purchase, like if you are on online purchasing of gold, silver or metal markets or stock prices. So you have softwares for the data collection of people who have interest in these areas, and the data is collected, the reviews are collected, and these reviews are shown through collaborative filtering to that class of customers who are generally involved in this technical purchases. So people can read each other's views about products and options and try to take their decisions according to the filtering which is available through websites and through also through media, which is a multi-channel and a multimedia impacting the customer's choice. The reports are there, the prices are there, the online variations are there, the updates are there, the weather reports are there, and the constant changes in prices are reflected, which is a collection of thoughts and expertise of various people working in that industry, collected and given to you in form of sharing and writing. Personalization is the consumer initiated practice of generating content on marketer's website that is custom tailored to an individual's specific needs and preferences. Now, personalization is also started by many big companies or websites because people have their personal preferences and choices. They have their personal problems regarding products, regarding solutions, because like if you have to take admission in a university which is situated somewhere in a different economy, now the admission dates are different, the procedures are different, the evaluation is different. How to calculate a percentage which is generally prevalent in an economy, how to convert it to a CGPA or credit rating. So personal problems are again country specific and region specific. So we can get personal information and ideas by directly connecting to the seller or to the vendor. Permission marketing. Permission marketing is the solicitation of consumer's consent called opt-in to receive an email and advertising based on personal data supplied by the consumer. Now, this is very popular because companies do ask for an email that can we drop our brochures or can we drop our promotions specifically according to the interest of the customers. So if you are interested, you can fill up that permission form or that email and the company will directly connect to you. Otherwise, the unsolicited marketing causes a lot of disturbance to the customers because it basically floods the emails and it is difficult for customers to read and to mark their emails, which becomes a kind of a big and a junky job for all people involved in this electronic business. The customer experience is the sum total of interactions that the customer has with the company's website from the initial look at the homepage through the entire purchase decision process. Now, customer is basically a client who is interacting daily to the websites and to the internet world for various needs, for search of knowledge, for search of prices, for search of solutions, or for search of entertainment. A life without media is practically impossible. Every time, at every specific need, we have a different kind of a desire. And this desire is basically fulfilled by the websites, which give you entertainment also, and they give you customization and a kind of a experience. So our experiences are individual and they are built through the kind of the content, the positivity and the entertainment value which most of the websites are giving to us. We take our decisions, we solve our problems, we look for mentorship, we look for guidance, and we go to the internet world and to the websites for reading, expressing your views, making your products popular, making yourself popular or selling your services, and having a say in politics or in social life has become easy through blogs. Now let's study viral marketing, which is impacting the daily life of people in a big way. Viral marketing is an internet-enabled promotional strategy that encourages individuals to forward marketer-initiated messages to otherwise via email. Now, viral marketing is important because we share our thoughts with people, we share our products with people. Viral marketing has impacted the company's strategies to decide on the positioning and branding options. Companies are making good videos and good promotions so that people can forward these items through the websites and through the emails to their friends and the families. Now let's study the summary of the total lecture. The total lecture was generally related to business to consumer transactions, where we were impacting and studying the online life of people. Here online shopping became important because we were discussing the positive advantages of convenience and cost to the customers. We were also studying the management of the supply chain, which has now become easy for the vendors. We were also studying the impact of the basic issues impacting the multi-channel and the multimedia customization and the personalization taken by the websites to the customers. The online shopping has increased, the impact has increased, the social life has changed, and people have got more freedom and convenience to connect to social forums for sharing their thoughts. Thank you, students.